cover all the topics on Cityline. This is one I don't feel like we've covered. It's all about passing gas. Bryce Wild is here. We all do it. We all do it. Come on.
Oh my God. We can talk about anything.
There's nothing that's off the table here on Cityline.
We're not embarrassed about this topic.
I'm not embarrassed.
I'm turning
about
a little
it.
Red, but it's all makeup.
I actually think passing gas is still hysterical at 42 years old. Yeah. But, you know, it's one of those things that we feel embarrassed about, and why are we doing it, and what's going on in our bodies, and is it okay? Like, is this a natural thing that should be happening? So you're going to quiz me on a few things. Now, it's going to be a true or false. So if the answer is true, you will hear this sound. If the answer is false, you will hear this sound.
That sounds like a wet one.
Ew. Okay. Question number one. All right. Chewing gum. You go.
Yeah,
for
chewing
it.
Gum.
Go
ahead. Does that actually cause more gas?
I have heard that that is true.
Really?
Yes.
Well, what is the answer? It is true. So anytime, So in fact.
Well, in fact,
even eating too quickly, anytime you're chewing gum, you're swallowing air. And then ultimately that becomes trapped and it's got to come out somewhere, right? So you're either going to burp it out or you're going to pass it out, all right?
Okay.
So question number two.
Yes.
If a king farts, is that a noble gas? That was a joke. That's not really.
False.
Air travel, does that make you fart?
I'm going to say false. Air travel does not make you fart.
What's the answer? Well, it's actually true.
It's true.
Well, hasn't anyone opened up a bottle of water mid-flight and it goes, psst, right? It was a regular. So gas expands the higher the altitude. Of course, the pressure, which is purposeful, the pressurized cabin will actually cause that belly to expand. So here's the tip.
Yeah.
You know, don't eat beans before you get on a long flight because it's going to happen even more, okay? You want to stay comfortable.
Brutal. And you're all locked up in a little container in the sky.
Yeah, absolutely. You're sitting real close to people even more and more these days, right? Yeah.
Okay,
so not
question.
A good idea. The older you get, the more gas you get. True or false?
I'm saying true on that one.
And the answer is? It is true.
Right?
So our motility, this is what it's all about. Motility means the amount of basically contractions that your gut has after you eat food, which is purposeful to get rid of what was out or down there, get that rid of and make more space for what's coming. So down the digestive tract here, ultimately this, the rectum, down there is where the gas is going to be, you know, trapped. And as you're older, you have less of a, you know, more of a challenge pushing that out, as well as having challenges with constipation.
That's why that happens.
Yep.
Okay, next question.
So the average person on a normal diet would pass about 5 to 10 farts in a day. True or false?
I'm going to say false because I think it's more than that.
You are. Right, you're right, it was false. So the idea is that we're actually passing more like 20 a day.
Oh,
and that's normal, so don't be embarrassed about it. You know, typically farts don't smell all that much unless you've, you know, got a lot of sulfur brewing up there. And the idea is, you know what, go ahead and find a washroom and pass that gas. Not a good idea to leave it down there, you know, grumbling and
so you're saying
unsettled.
Don't try and do like the bum clench and like
don't
hold it
do
in.
Don't do the bum clench. Don't do
let
the bum
it
clench.
Out, people. You know, let it out. Body is doing what it should be doing 20 times a day. Oh my gosh.
How about bad smelling farts? Do you think that's because you're sick or there's a problem down there if they smell?
I would say that's false. There's no problem.
So and the answer is? You're absolutely right. It is false. So it doesn't mean that you're sick just because they smell bad. Again, it's the sulfur brewing.
Yeah.
You know, and a lot of folks make this misunderstanding. That, you know, by the way, 5 million Canadians, we have more of this problem across our country than any other country. We haven't figured out why have irritable bowel syndrome.
Really?
Which includes either diarrhea, constipation, and lots of gassiness. So as Canadians, we're passing more than most. That's probably why we have a problem with our ozone layer. You know, so, that's my opinion. That's not scientific,
we're
by the way.
We're a farty population up here.
So how about foods high in protein? Do you think that would ultimately make you fart more or cause stinkier farts?
I'm going to say false on that one.
And the answer? It's also false. You're
I
on.
Know my
She's
farts.
Getting, yeah, you're beyond the 50s. You know your farts.
I know my farts.
It's absolutely true. It's absolutely true. Nothing
to
worry about.
Ask me one more
Last
question.
One, exercise. Do you think that helps you to pass gas and ultimately fart less?
I'm going to say true on that one.
All right. And you would be? Right. Right.
Yes.
So it's true. So one thing to do is to practice maybe belly breathing, really pull your stomach in, clench your stomach, and then release. Right. What that does is ultimately create more tone and helps you to pass gas a little bit easier. So don't forget that. And even, by the way, doing sit-ups can help, you know, just getting that excess gas out. Right.
Now, so all of these foods are things that may make you gassy. So it's not like you're eating bad things.
Right.
All
so
the
take
time
note, you know,
gassy.
The melons in particular, cauliflower, kale, cabbage in particular, you know, even avocado, beans, beans, the musical fruit, the more you eat, the more you
toot.
The more you toot, the better you feel sweet beans with every meal, but you're going to toot more. Yes. Lactose intolerance, that could be a problem. Coffee and caffeinated beverages.
Yeah.
So all these cause a lot more gas. If you're already gassed, you might want to avoid that. You know, carminatives, which means essentially helps to relieve gas and decrease bloating. Mm-hmm. And, you know, ginger is an anti-inflammatory. So anise, you might have heard of that.
Star anise.
So this tastes like licorice. You know, smell that. I love that stuff. Caraway seeds. All these seeds are going to do is, in caraway, you know from pumpernickel bread.
That's right.
So they're going to reduce the amount of gas in your stomach as a carminative. They'll also, and you know, ginger is another example, it's got gingerols, anti-inflammatory, but they'll also measurably decrease the amount of spasms. So the more you're spasming, the more you're passing gas.
Right.
An amazing study done, which showed actually Health Canada now uses a claim, which is amazing, on soluble fiber that not only treats irritable bowel syndrome and reduces constipation, even in kids, by the way. The only other claim for children, by the way, used to be prune juice.
Yes.
It's got to be so safe and effective,
right.
But now it's soluble fiber, which is amazing. So this one is one of our own Canadians, Lorna Vanderhage. What she created was soluble fiber with probiotics called Regular Girl.
Uh-huh.
This stuff, it just mixes into water. It's
so
tasteless,
keep
odorless.
So you in your system and you get rid of the fiber.
Bingo.
Right,
So the idea is feeding the good bacteria. They need to eat as well. Just soluble fiber.
Just
it's the Regular Girl. You're a regular girl. So keeping you regular, reducing gas by feeding the good bacteria. When there's too much bad bacteria in there, you're making more gas. So we got to regulate this. It's called dysbiosis, imbalance good and bad bacteria.
Okay.
Lastly, reach for the chamomile and not green tea, chamomile and peppermint tea. Peppermint's got an amazing ability to relax the intestines.
Really good information.
Yeah,
you know, my only takeaway from that is let your farts out.
And that should be the number one takeaway of the show.